Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to replace your spark plugs and ignition coils on a BMW. I've got the B46/B48 right here, but this is gonna be more of a generic video. Changing the spark plugs and ignition coils is pretty much the same process for any modern direct injected BMW engine. I'm gonna go ahead and specifically show it to you guys on the B46/B48. We've also got an N54 sitting over here, and so I'm gonna show you a couple differences between the two just so that you can see what a different BMW engine might look like depending on what you've got. For this install, we don't really need too many crazy tools. All we need is a wrench with a long extension so that we can reach all the way down into the spark plug wells. And then the one thing that you will need is a specialty spark plug removal tool. Because these spark plugs sit facing downwards in a deep well, if you don't have a specialty spark plug grabber, you're not gonna be able to actually get the spark plug out of the spark plug hole. This basically is just a spark plug remover, but it has a little O-ring in it, and that O-ring will latch on to the spark plug so that when you go to pull the old spark plugs out, it will pull the spark plug out with it. Without this, you will not be able to get the spark plugs out of the spark plug hole. I'll go ahead and link to where you can purchase this online. I believe they're like 10 bucks. And that's really the only specialty tool you need. Outside of that, for this B48 right here, we do need an E8 socket. We've got that, and then the spark plugs. Here we've got the OEM NGK 94201 spark plugs. If you guys need spark plugs, head over to bmwsparkplugs.com or BMW Parts Factory where we sell them. These are just the direct OEM replacements, but on something like our N54s here, we're running either one-step or two-step colder spark plugs. So if you do have some performance modifications, you might want to consider running a step or two steps colder. We have those available at bmwsparkplugs.com, as well as a helpful guide that will let you know which spark plugs you need depending on how much horsepower you're running. So let's go ahead and get over here and we'll go ahead and jump into the DIY. The first step is going to be removing the engine cover. All of these engine covers are very easy to remove. The one right here is solely held on by a couple grommets, and so you just want to pull up on it in a couple different places and it pulls right off like that. Now on some of the other engines like the N54, there's like three bolts that hold the cover down, but this one's just an easy removal right there. On the B46, B48, this is going to give us full access to all of our spark plugs and ignition coils, which you can see right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now on some other engines, like if we come on over here to the N54, you will have to remove the cowl. The cowl being the large piece that kind of sits back here over the top of the hood. We've got those removed on these vehicles because we have the cowl filters from Berger Motorsports here. But on this N54, as you can see, the 6 spark plug and ignition coil sit pretty far in the back right here. And so if you don't have the cowl removed, you're not going to be able to access it because you have to get your spark plug tool going down behind this support bracket right here. Over here on this B48, we don't have to remove the cowl because the 4th one is right here. Since this is an inline 4, the engines are a little bit shorter, and so it's a little bit easier to access the very back spark plug. From here, the first step is getting the ignition coils out. On the B48, we've just got one clip right here, which is the electrical connector that powers the ignition coil. So we're gonna wanna remove those. And then these ignition coils are held in by a bolt, and that is an E8 socket that you need to remove those bolts. And then that should give us access to pull the ignition coils out. Before I do that, let's just go ahead and head back to the N54. The B48 is a little bit, I don't wanna say more challenging because those are still very easy to remove, but on something like the N54, it's extremely easy to get the ignition coils out. On these ones, you just pop up and then the connector automatically pulls right out. And then you just put your finger in here or you can put your wrench in there and just pull upwards. And then the whole ignition coil is gonna come out and give you access to the spark plug down in there. All right, let's head on back over here and I'm gonna go ahead and get these connectors off and go ahead and loosen all the bolts. What you wanna do is take a flathead screwdriver and pop the top up on it. You would think that this would just come off now with the top popped up on it, but I still couldn't get it to come off. What I did is then just took the flathead screwdriver, a very small one, and put it right underneath the front where you can see the little clip hanging around, and then you can unclip it from the bottom and then it'll pull right out. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pop these other two off. I'm gonna undo these 4 bolts and then we'll pull the ignition coils off. So I'll just go ahead and show you one of them right here, and then I'll go ahead and do the rest off of camera. We've got the bolt loosened, we've got the connector undone, and so now the ignition coil, if you just grab it, wiggle and use a little bit of force, it should pop right out. This little bolt doesn't actually fully come out. On this car, I'm only changing the spark plugs, but if you wanted to change the ignition coil, you would just go ahead and pop a new one back in once you get the spark plug out. From here, we've got the spark plug all the way down in the spark plug hole right here. We're gonna use our specialty spark plug remover. We're gonna feed this down into there and then start loosening it. And then once you get it fully loosened, it will pull the old spark plug out just like that. From here, it's really pretty simple. You're gonna wanna take your new spark plug, put it in, make sure that your O-ring is still in your specialty spark plug tool, and then you're going to push it all the way in, just like that. Put it back down in here. And then we're gonna tighten it. Now you can use spark plug grease or some type of anti-seize on it if you would like. We change our spark plugs pretty frequently. On something like this B48 here, we'll probably change them every 40 to 50,000 miles just since this car doesn't have any performance modifications on it. On the ignition coils, like I said, I'm not changing them this time. We'll probably change the ignition coils every 80,000 miles, or maybe, you know, the next time we change the spark plugs, we'll go ahead and change those as well. On something like our N54s, since those are all pushing pretty big power and we're running the two-step colder spark plugs, those things only last probably 12 to 15,000 miles. And so we'll replace the spark plugs a lot more frequently, and we'll do the ignition coils probably every 25 to 30,000 miles on those too. Now I'm gonna remove the fourth one as well and just make sure that I can access the fourth spark plug down here. I think I can because I've got some long enough wrench extenders here, but there are a lot of people that I've seen online go through the whole process of removing the cowl here, which is not something that I particularly want to do. It's not tough to do, it's just is a couple extra steps that are a little bit of a hassle. So I'm gonna try to not remove it if I don't have to. Second ignition coil out. Now you can also tell if an ignition coil is starting to go bad. We pulled this first one out and that first one actually looks pretty good right there. The second one, you can see we're starting to get a little bit of browning on the tip of it. That usually happens when you have a little bit of some oil or kind of fuel getting into the ignition coil there, which can cause them to go bad a little bit more quickly, but it's just a little bit of dirt and dust on this one. So nothing too bad, but if you do visually inspect them, you are generally able to see like how decent condition they are in. And the last thing I'd mention is just to make sure that your ignition coils go back in the same holes. It doesn't particularly matter as long as one of your ignition coils isn't bad. It's not gonna mess things up, but I always like to just take them and line them up in the cylinder order so that I know which one goes where. And there's the fourth ignition coil. Now, if you pull any of these out and you notice that you've got a lot of oil on the end of them, or if any of your old spark plugs are really wet and kind of dripping with oil, that means that you probably have a valve cover gasket leak, and that will cause your spark plugs and ignition coils to go bad a bit more frequently. There we go. So I am able to get to the fourth spark plug on this. This is a 530i xDrive. I know the engine layout, depending on whether it's a 5, 4, 3 series, etc., is a little bit different, but fortunately on this one, I do not have to remove any of the cowls to get the fourth spark plug out. So that is good news. I'm gonna go ahead and get the rest of the spark plugs pulled out of here, replaced. And then I'll just briefly show you guys the process of putting the coils back in. All right, guys, I got all the spark plugs out. I already installed one, which I showed you guys. So I've got the three new ones here, and then here are all the four old ones. I know they look bad visually. These really aren't the worst, but definitely time to replace them. So good thing we're getting some new ones in there. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how to get the ignition coil back on there. If you look at the bottom of these, it's really just a rubber boot that connects onto the top of the spark plug. You're just gonna want to press them down and make sure you get enough force on them to where it fully absorbs the spark plug and gets on there completely. We're just gonna go ahead and put the ignition coil back in, orient it where this bolt is lining up with the bolt hole, and then you just want to press it down and make sure it has fully gotten onto the spark plug. And then from there, all we need to do is reconnect our connectors, which go on a lot easier than they come off, if I might say. And then we will tighten down the bolt right here. If after you finish this DIY, you're having any misfiring or rough idling or any issues like that, the problem could be with the spark plug gap, especially if you're getting one step or two step colder. Since these are OEM, they're already gapped properly. But your issue could be with a spark plug gap. It could be that you didn't fully seat the ignition coil onto the spark plug, or you maybe didn't get the ignition coil connector back on properly. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our generic BMW DIY spark plug and ignition coil guide. This B48 is slightly less friendly than our N54 over there, but even this is really at max a 30-minute DIY. It's super easy, you don't need that many tools, and if you take your car to the BMW dealership, first of all, they're probably gonna charge you like $30 a spark plug, maybe even more, and they're probably gonna get you for at least an hour, but maybe 2 hours of labor. And so at a dealer rate of, you know, $200+ an hour, they're going to really get you on spark plugs when it's something that just about anyone with basic mechanical knowledge can do in their garage in under an hour easily. Anyways, guys, if you appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more of our BMW videos.